Welcome back. Well, no matter how green we imagine we are, with fuel prices rising, electric cars have never looked more attractive. And that's why international car makers are pouring truckloads of money into developing the people movers of the future. But there is one little company north of Melbourne that plans to show the big boys a trick or two. Here's 6.30's environment reporter Emily Rice.
These cars have great bodies, but it's what's inside that counts. Instead of a big petrol engine, this high-performance BMW runs on hybrid diesel-electric technology.
This car will go 0 to 100 in 4.8 seconds, but only use 3.7 litres per 100k. So incredible performance, but also incredible efficiency.
Most manufacturers at this year's International Motor Show have revealed new fuel-efficient and eco-friendly cars. Audi's pure electric e-tron oozes sex appeal and sustainability. And Toyota is making a song and dance about its new Prius models. While distinct in style, these sustainable wheels share many similarities. All boast ultra-low emissions, cost millions to create, and most are not yet on Australian roads. But a few hundred kilometres away in country Victoria, there's a little Australian company that's been rolling out electric cars for more than 4 years. The Blade Electron is the first Australian pure electric vehicle to be fully licensed and crash tested. Using a Hyundai body, they're produced in a small factory using local workers.
We're just like any other vehicle manufacturer, except we're just small scale.
An 8-hour charge from a home power point or just 2 hours from a public station keeps the current model going for 120 kilometres.
We're about a year and a half away from above 300 kilometres. In terms of the range of these vehicles.
These little Blade Electrons are extremely quiet. They don't release any emissions, but can still go pretty fast, up to 120 kilometres an hour. Now the next model, which is still in production, will go even faster, up to 160 k's.
They cost $45,000 up front, but just a few dollars a week to run.
We're already at a point now where 5 years out, these vehicles will pay for themselves.
The Electron's price and power rivals the only other electric vehicle currently on the road, the Mitsubishi i-MiEV, which is made in Japan. The local council is one of more than 40 satisfied Electron customers.
It's really easy, drives smoothly, sits on the road nicely. It's a beautiful little suburban runaround car.
But it's a long road for small vehicle manufacturers. Mr. Blade says he's had little support from some suppliers, has lost out on fleet deals to bigger manufacturers, and is still waiting for the federal government to meet an election promise to purchase one of his cars.
Is it difficult for a small operator in this market?
Oh, absolutely. It's tough. It's very tough. We've had a number of discussions with the ACCC about behaviour that we felt was anti-competitive.
But the obstacles won't slow him down.
So we have a number of firsts. So we're writing our page in Australian automotive history, and we're proud of that.